everyone, this is Sissy from Little Bench. Today I've come up with another recycle craft. As you can see, this is an old pizza delivery box which I had at my home. Now I'm going to show you how to convert this into a beautiful photo frame. For that I need this portion, the portion without any folds. Now let me cut this out. I need two similar pieces. So I got one piece, I'm going to cut out one more piece from the other side. If you find this difficult, I have provided a downloadable link in the description box. You can take a printout of that and trace it onto the cardboard sheet. These are the two cardboard pieces which we cut now. Now I'm taking one piece. I'm going to draw the photo frame template onto the center of this cardboard sheet. You can do it in different ways. The easiest method is to take any rectangular shaped book, keep it on the cardboard and trace the outer border of the book. Now you can cut it out. The problem with this method is we need to take the printout of the photo in this book's dimension. Then only the photo will fit in this window. Now I'm going to show you how to make a customized photo frame of width 5 inch and length 7 inch. I have taken a rectangular cardstock paper. Mark 5 inch width and 7 inch length from a corner. Now let's cut it out. Keep this paper on the cardboard and trace the outer border. Now you can cut this out. Use a cutter so that you will get smooth cut at the corners. Thus we made the inner window of our frame. Next step is to mark and cut the frame width. Let's take our scale's width as the thickness of the frame. My scale is 1 inch wide. So keep the scale towards the outside of the rectangle like this and draw lines. Repeat this step for all the four sides. Now we got a bigger outer rectangle. Let's cut this out. Thus we got the front piece of our frame. Now we need to make a backing for our frame. For that, take the other cardboard piece and trace the outer border of the frame onto that. Now let's cut it out. So this is the backing and this is the frame. So now we need a little space between the frame and the backing so that we can insert the photo through that space. So I have cut three rectangular pieces of cardboard. Now I'm going to attach it like this. One here and one here. And this portion we are leaving so that there will be a little space, and through that space we are going to insert our photo.
Apply white glue and stick the rectangular pieces onto the back piece of the frame. Don't use hot glue because it won't give you that neat finish. Now let's apply glue on the top of the strips and attach the front piece of the frame onto this. Thus we have finished making the frame. As you can see, there is a gap between the pieces at one side through which we can insert the picture. All the other sides we have closed. To make the photo frame stand erect, take a rectangular strip of cardboard and cut one side to a slanting shape like this. Make a fold at the top portion and using hot glue, fix the folded portion to the back of the frame.
So this is the photo frame which we made now. Now you can decorate this with anything. Now I am going to show you how to decorate this with popsicle sticks. These are the popsicle sticks. It's also known as ice cream sticks or craft sticks. You can get this from any craft store. Or you can buy this online. I'll provide the link.
I am cutting off the rounded ends of the popsicle sticks. Now it looks like small wooden pieces. You can cut it into smaller pieces of random length. Once you have cut a fair amount of popsicle sticks, it is time to start gluing them onto the frame. Start from any corner and complete one full row around the frame. When the ends are not fitting in the space, I cut the sticks and made up sizes. Once you finish that row, move on to the inner row, again starting from the corner. To make the whole frame more rustic, the wooden pieces need to be scattered. When gluing down the sticks, make sure that none of the seams are in line with each other. Now we have finished gluing the sticks. You can color it to your desired color. Since I want to give a rustic look to my frame, I am using this wood stain. If you don't have this, you can substitute it with strong tea or dark soy sauce. That will also give you a stained look. I'm applying just one coat. If you are using soy sauce, you might have to go for 3 to 4 coats. Once the paint is dry, I sandpapered it to give a vintage look. Finally, I applied some glue to the backing of the frame and inserted a white cardstock. I have cut a clear OHP sheet to the same size of my photo and inserted it to the frame together with the photo.
That's all about today's project. Don't get confused about the sandpaper thing or the wooden paint which I used. You can use whichever paint you have at your house. Another option is, before fixing the sticks onto the frame, you can paint the sticks to different colors. And then you can cut it into small pieces and assemble it onto the frame. So you'll get a multicolored frame. That is also a very good option. Once you make the cardboard frame, you can decorate it with anything. You can use pearls to decorate it. You can use buttons or you can use masking tapes of different colors. Plenty of options are there. Let your imagination work and create your own unique frames. One more thing I want to tell you. I love to promote the creativity of the children. So those kids who are trying this and would love to exhibit their creations can send it to me through my FB page or Instagram account, or you can mail me. I'll publish your pictures in my page. Let your creativity be an inspiration to others. Let's inspire each other and grow together. That's all for the day.